Hello, beautiful people. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Paige. This is Seeking Alexandria. And guys, we have a couple things we need to talk about. So number one, I did a little something different with my hair. I'm trying this center part with like a wavy type deal. And I think it looks really cute. Like normally I wouldn't rock a center part, but I think with my hair having this kind of a texture at this length being bobbed, I think it looks really cute. You guys can tell me what you think down below. And then also real quick too, this top that I'm wearing is from Fabletics. And you may or may not hear this same spiel over in the foundation review that's going to be going up here in a couple of days, but I'm wearing this top from Fabletics, and I asked you guys over on Instagram last week if you wanted to see a full review, because what I did, I have been so curious about Fabletics for so long, and I feel like everyone that talks about it is so sponsored, and it drives me nuts. So I went on and I placed an order. Like, I signed up, I got the coupon, I did all the things, and I placed an order. And we're talking like leggings and joggers and jackets like this, zip up, quarter zip, shirt. I did a little bit of everything because I really want to test it out and see what I think. What I want to know from you guys is if you'd be interested in a Fabletics review, because not only am I plus size, but it's also not sponsored. I bought everything myself. But I feel like that is something that is sorely lacking in like the Fabletics market, especially when it comes to plus size and not sponsored. Like, hello, put everything together. If that's something you guys want to see, let me know down below. But yeah, that's what's going on here. Now let's go ahead and talk about today's actual video, the reason that you are here. And that is, of course, the Little Huda nude palettes. I did pick up all three, and we're going to talk about them here in a second. But guys, I'm going to be so honest with you, like brutally honest, these almost, and I mean, they were like one boop away from being in an anti-haul, because when I looked at these, I was like, girl, $29 and I'm gonna buy a nude ass palette. No, thank you. And when I saw them for some reason on the internet, like they launched, and I was like, no. And then I, like, next thing I know, I was purchasing them because I just love them so much. Like, I don't know what it is about these, but the aesthetic of these palettes to me is just everything and then some. Now, here's the only downside. This is the reason that for me, this video is going in a completely wrong direction, because normally when I'm going to film a video like this, I will sit down, I'll do swatches, I'll have everything ready to insert, because I really like to be prepared. However, this little guy showed up. This is the deepest one. And oh, just watch as everything pours out from this container. It arrived obliterated. Like, yeah, that's cute. Literally, three of my shades are completely destroyed. And all three of them are the beautiful, like, shimmery metallic-y shades. And I don't, again, I'm not sure how well you can see it, but it's this one, and this one over here. It's just destroyed. So for this one, I will go ahead and swatch what I can just so you can see most of it on my skin tone. Get off me. Okay, so I went ahead, I moved you guys in, and I think we're going to do these in reverse order. So I'm going to start with the deep, then the medium, and then the light. Now, obviously, the deep one is quite literally destroyed. I did go ahead and empty the pans, but these are the ones that are left, and it's a little pathetic. So I'm going to go ahead and throw up on the screen for you guys an actual photo of the palette as well as the swatches, just so you obviously know what you're getting. Now, I did also go ahead and swatch the remaining ones on my hand here, and what I do like about this palette is the depth that it goes to. I really like how deep and sultry the colors get. Everything has a really nice creamy consistency. And looking at the ones that are missing in the palette, like the ones that broke in mine, I do really feel like those colors would be essential to this palette, because those really give it like a nice little bit of brightness. I went ahead and I tucked my hair back, and I'm going to prime my lids here with my Tarte Shape Tape in Porcelain Beige. And in the description here, it says that these were created to suit every skin tone and eye color, each palette containing an incredible shade range. From butter mattes, super shimmery shadows, and complementary metallic shades, all with smooth and blendable textures, available in three nude themes, again, to really make sure that you can hit every single skin tone, undertone, eye color, all of that. And I'm really happy that they took this route and they didn't just make like one nude palette. Like, the fact that they went through and really recognized, hey, yes, nude is not a color. Nude is a shade range. It is a skin tone range. It goes from light to deep. I'm a really big fan of that. All right, guys, so I went ahead and I patted out the Tarte Shape Tape Porcelain Beige, and I think I'm going to get started in this palette with this nice little nude shade right in the center. I'm going to be taking this on a Morphe E23, and I think I'm going to just work it through the center of the lid. So this shade is gorgeous, and it blends beautifully. Now, next up, I'm going to take this shade with the same brush, and I'm just going to start working that that and deepening up the outer V. I really love these colors. Wow, is that beautiful. Like that tone and undertone, those two mixed together, I think it's stunning. And I feel like you can really deepen up either of those shades if you're just in a hurry and you don't want to keep going in like color to color to color and going back and forth. I feel like you could do a lot with those because they really do deepen up and just blend stunningly. But for all over the lid, this is where it's going to get a little challenging because, again, I am more of a fair skin toned lady here. But I think I'm going to try. There's like a little bit left in this little gold pan right here. And I'm like dead set on using that. So I'm going to take my little NYX glitter glue and I'm going to put that all over the lid here real quick. Now I'm going to dig my finger as much as I can into that little pan right there. And I'm going to try and apply. Oh crap. See, here's the situation. I just realized as I did that, that's not the gold shade. That's like the gold shade and the shade that was next to it mixed together. I apologize. Oh well. Guys, it's just, you know what? We're just having fun. This one we're just gonna have fun with because I really don't have much of a choice here. Oh wow, but those are pretty mixed together. And then I'm gonna take this other shimmery shade in the palette, the one that didn't break, and I'm just gonna pop that on the outer portion of my eye and just kind of blend it in. I'm not adding any glitter glue or anything. I'm just using it to blend. Ooh, that's pretty. Okay. Because I figured with this palette, I can't really do much like specifically because obviously almost half of it's missing, but I still wanted to go in and see how everything applied. And that's really, really pretty. Dang. Something I would have to do to make this whole thing work, obviously, I like to have a little bit more of like a bright inner eye area. I would probably take like Clutch right here, maybe even T out of this Pixie palette or any nice gold highlight that you have. And I would be inclined to kind of pop that over top. Okay, guys, so I'm having a little bit of an issue. This palette is continuing to crumble out of control. And I think it's because the pans themselves were somehow damaged in transit. Like maybe they were shook, like the formula was shook out of them. Because now the mattes are starting to crumble a little bit. And it's not like a crumble, like a shimmer crumbles. It's more so like a break apart. Everything's really loose and fluffy. And every time I open it and touch into it, I'm literally just getting fluff everywhere. So I am going to stop right here. I'm not going to touch these anymore. We're just going to pretend that this side is done. And what do you guys think? I really love this. Again, just for kind of like a play with it, Mod Podge kind of look. I think it turned out really nicely. And I think out of this palette, what I enjoy the most is that these colors are so rich. Like the pigmentation is there. I do think that they worked really nicely. And from what I could see of them, they did blend really well. And out of that, the only color that didn't swatch well or the best is this one right here. And that is the dark matte purple. It's the darkest one in the palette. And when I was swatching it, I do feel like it had a little bit more dryness to it. Now it still has a nice creamy look and feel, but like if I just go in here and try to swatch it, like I have to really get back and forth and really build up that depth. All right, so now diving into the medium palette, here we go with that one. This is what the palette itself looks like, and then these are the 9 swatches. And out of this palette too, I do feel like those shimmers are the star by a long shot. I think that they are gorgeous. Not to say that the mattes aren't nice. Again, they did swatch nicely and they're buttery, they're creamy, but I feel like the mattes in here really just complement the shimmers. Like they're a vessel for the shimmer, if you will. I'm gonna go in again here and apply myself some Tarte Shape Tape and Porcelain Beige to the lid. Starting off with this palette here, I'm gonna take the Morphe R35 and I think I'm going to dive in with this nice little light pink shade over here. I'm going to start by running that through the crease on the inner portion of the eye right there. And I don't wanna deepen this shade up too much. I want it to be nice and light and kind of a fluffy kind of pink. You really just run it all over that inner portion. So I really like the way that that shade both builds and maintains a nice amount of brightness to it. Like even though I built up the depth a little bit, I feel like it still stayed nice and a light pink. Now from there, I'm gonna grab this pink shade down here and I am going to fluff that through the middle portion right through here just to start adding some depth of color. Ooh, that's a pretty shade. Dang, and that applied like instantly. Did you see that color? It was just like, boom, done. Actually, and you know what? I'm gonna take this all the way through the crease too. But did you see that color? It just like instantly applies. That's really pretty. What else I'm really loving about this is the way that it blends into the eye. I feel like it's diffusing effortlessly. Like these are slightly powdery, so I'm getting a tiny amount of kick, but the blend is just beautiful. Like it's not overly done. It's not too much. It's not enough. It's a perfect amount of blend for me. Now from there, I am gonna dive into this dark shade, same brush. Everything has been done on this Morphe R35. And I'm going to take and put that just on the outer V a little bit just to deepen everything up. I don't want it to be overly deep. I just want like a little bit right there, like just to create this nice like light little wing effect, and then just kind of blend that light little wing effect up a freckle just to make sure that it meshes in with the brow bone. Ooh, that's pretty. And also, you might notice with these looks that I'm doing, I haven't been going near my lower lash line, obviously just because the final palette, I'm going to use that one on the lower lash line. And for me, I feel like when it comes to the lower lash line, a lot of times I just take like two colors that I used on the upper lid and I put them on the lower lash line. Like, I don't do anything overly significant down there anyways. And I was trying to figure out, like, I'm starting to freak myself out. I was like over dramatizing it per usual, right? And I was like, oh my God, like, what am I gonna do? How am I gonna do the lower lash line? And then it occurred to me, Paige, it's not that serious. It's a lower lash line. Everybody knows you. They know you would just take the dark matte color and you'd put it on. Like, it's not that serious. So I apologize if you don't know me. I'm so basic when it comes to the lower lash line. All right, but anyways, that being said, I deepened up the outer V a little bit more than just that light little wing flick because I was really liking the depth of color and I love the way that those pinks all complement each other. And I really love that dark purple. Like, that's a beautiful color. Now, because I'm not going to be wearing this all day, I made the crucial mistake with the last palette and I used the glitter glue. And instead of doing that, I'm just going to go straight in with my finger. Normally, I would put down a glitter glue though. And I'm going to dive in to that beautiful duochrome pink shade right here. Ooh, girl, it's so pretty. Guys, just kidding. I have to go in with my NYX glitter glue. And you want to know why? Because I have the curse of the most textured eyelids known to mankind, and literally nothing will even stick to them without glitter glue. Lovely. So I'm going to pat down some of this, and now I'm going to go in with the shimmer. Oh yeah, look at that. There we go. Seriously, what is wrong with my eyelids, honey? Oh, comment down below. I know so many of you also have inhospitable eyelids. Girl, it is a journey. Okay, but seriously, that is so worth the journey because look at that color. I love it. I am going to grab a little bit of this gold shade right here and pop that in the center. I think I just want to add a little bit of brightness right through there just to kind of break things up a little bit. And I'm not really adding much. I'm just adding a tiny, tiny amount, just enough so it creates a little bit of light in the center, like a veiling of that color. And then I'm just kind of wiping it through. Oh, that's beautiful. And then on the outer V, I'm going to take this dark little shimmer and I'm going to tap it out here. And again, this is more so just a veiling of it. I'm not doing this like I did with the deep palette. I'm just lightly tapping the tiniest amount of that color just to blend it through with that matte shade. Lately, I've been really into this look where I mix my matte and my shimmers together and I kind of blend them in. Because I think it adds like this nice little glossy look. Like, if you veil it over top, not go in and super concentrate it like I did right here, but on the outer V, just lightly veil the shimmer. Girl! It's so pretty. I'll just love me a little glossy eyeball. Like, how do you not love to be glossy? Now, y'all, I just apologize. This video is not going the way that I intended for it to. I'm going to stop here again because this eye is basically done, short of me adding like a nice little highlight pop. You guys know I do that for every look. But the problem I'm having is that this eye over here has watered for 3 days. And so it's a little bit raw on the corner. And the thought of adding a glitter glue to this eye and wiping it off, it literally makes me want to cry. So I'm really sorry. Let's just go ahead and, again, pretend this is done. Hello, hi. She's pretending. But I want to hear from you guys. This is look number two. What do you think? Now, I myself am holding all of my thoughts and commentary until the very end, so I'm not going to tell you like, oh, I think that this versus the medium versus the deep or what have you. I'm just waiting until I have all of my thoughts gathered, and I'm going to give you just a wrap up at the end. So this is the second look. Again, let's just not look at her. Look at her. So pretty, so reflective, so glossy. And I'm going to go ahead and move into the final look. I didn't plan on today's video going like this either. I really thought today's video would be just fine. Everything would be great. And then I opened the box and I saw that it was broken and I was like, this is just not going to be my day. Nope. So if you're new here, hello, I promise I'm normally much better put together. Things are just so many things happening. But subscribe, stick around. 5 days a week. I promise it gets better. I promise. All right. So now because this is the final eye look, I'm actually going through as well and giving myself a little bit of a concealed brow. And who are we kidding? I also have to cover up copious amounts of purple eyeshadow from my two previous looks. So we're really just doing the whole thing, but I think that this is going to look really, really pretty. All right, guys, so I went ahead and I swatched it, and first of all, I am obsessed with these swatches. This purple right here, oh my God, it's like the lightest, like kind of periwinkle, light little dusty purple. Like I would consider this like a Tinkerbell purple. Now for this look, I wanna do something a little bit different, and I'm going to start off with this purple shade right here, and I'm taking this on the Morphe M452. And I'm going to start off by really just placing this one right through the crease right here. And I'm really going to pack it on. Now from there, I want to diffuse the top side of that a little bit more with this nice light pink shade right here. And I'm gonna do it on the same brush because I don't really care if the shades mix or anything. I just wanna get a little bit of that light pink kind of fluffing up toward the brow bone. I think it'll really soften it. Oh, wow. That light pink is such a nice, like, light Barbie pink, and it builds up to a really soft, subtle pink. Oh, wow, that's pretty. I'm actually gonna go ahead and grab that bone color shade right here, and I'm gonna take this on a random Wet n Wild little flat, fluffy pecker brush thing that I've had for, I don't know, like, multiple years. I don't even know where this came from. I've had it for so long, and I'm gonna use that color up here toward the brow bone, and I'm basically going to blend out that area just a little bit. For me, that is what these shades are good for. Okay, now from here, I'm going to take this fluffy little brush. This is the Morphe Y19, and it is fluffy, but it has a nice kind of tapered point to it, and I'm going in with this for a very specific reason, because I am going to very, very lightly dive in to this deep brown right here, and I want to deepen up my outer V, just a freckle, without making it too dark here. So I'm just depositing that color and then really lightly working it up. Just a little bit. You can kind of see the two melding. So I'm just very lightly really working those two colors together and making sure that the combination is nice and integrated. It goes more like this than just here's purple, here's brown, and you can see where they start and stop. I don't like that at all. And I think the two of these are blending together beautifully, and it's giving me the most subtle, perfect amount of depth. I'm also going to do this here on the inner portion of the eye. Okay, so now we are finally going to grab the glitter glue, and we're gonna start applying this all over the lid. Now, this is going to be a halo eye type situation, so I'm just gonna take it on my finger here, and I am going to apply it primarily in the center, and then lightly kind of fan it through both sides. And then I'm going to go in first here with this pink shade. This is like that nice light little duochrome kind of pink to light kind of mossy green shift. And I am going to pack that all over the lid. Oh, wow, that's a beautiful shade. Now, this one did give me a tiny bit of fallout. I think that's just because the shimmers in this palette seem to be a little bit more glittery than they were in the other palettes. I feel like I didn't have much, if any, like glitter type fallout in those. And I am going to take over top of that here a little bit of this purple. And I want to just kind of layer that purple just over top of it in the center. And what I'm going to do is build these two shades together. To go back in and give myself a little definition, I'm grabbing that Morphe Y19, and I'm going to throw a little bit of the purple shade, the one that we originally worked through the crease, and then I'm going to take a little bit of that brown as well and kind of layer it out here. And what ends up happening when I do this that I really love is I get the nice, subtle amount of depth that I'm looking for without it being so apparent. Like, it's not an overly aggressive, like, wow, here's your depth, here's the light and the dark and the da-da-da. It ends up being a nice built-in layer depth that I just really, really like. Kind of like a good cheeseburger. You know what I'm talking about? Like, everything's layered in there. You got the bun, then you got this amazing, super delicious burger, then you got some cheese, and girl, that cheese is so good. And then pickles, and then some condiments, maybe a little bit of them fried little onions. Maybe you got some crispy onion rings on there. A burger with onion rings or fries on top is delicious. And then everything is topped off with that bun. And it doesn't mean that all those little pieces aren't in there. It just means that they're layered in there perfectly so that every moment of it is delicious. Just like an eye look. Did I just single-handedly build the bridge between a burger and makeup? I think I did, and I think I love myself even more now than I did when I woke up. Yes. Now, on the lower lash line, I'm gonna grab some of that purple that we originally, again, worked through the crease here, and I'm going to throw that all over the lower lash line. I'm going to grab that brown shade, and I'm gonna throw that as well on the inner and outer V. And then I'm gonna grab just a tiny little hit of the NYX Glitter Glue, and I'm taking this on the Refer Brush 03, the little pencil brush here, and I'm going to pop some of that glitter glue right up under my lower lashes, and then I'm going in with that duochrome, and I'm going to pack a little bit of that down there. Then, just like I did before, I'm gonna layer a little bit of the purple on it. Just create that same little layering sandwich that I did up above on the lower lash line. Did I just stab myself in the eye? Yep, sure did. Woo, girl. A little bit pokey. Now, instead of going in with a liner or anything, I'm going to grab my Sigma E65 small angle, and I'm taking a tiny bit of the dark brown, and I am going to really press this into my lash line on the upper lash right here. Just a little bit, and I'm kind of going to smudge it out. I just want a little bit of definition, but I don't really want to go in and make anything overly dark. And all right, beautiful people, I am back. This is how the look came together. What do you think? Eye combo, lip, the whole shebang. I really like the way that those two go together. I went a little bit darker on the lip with the Revlon Ultra HD Vinyl Lip Polish in Date Night. This is one of my favorites. I believe it was actually in last month's favorites of makeup products that I just can't stop using. And I literally haven't stopped even since then because it's beautiful and it pairs so well with everything. And what I wanted to do with this eye look, because it was so nice and light and airy and kind of whimsical, I wanted to just add a tiny bit of depth to just round everything out. And I'm obsessed with the way it turned out. Like, I love everything about it. Now, I do want to take a second here at the tail end of this video, like I mentioned earlier, to go through and give kind of my thoughts and opinions overall as far as the collection, the palettes, so on and so forth. But before I do that, I did go ahead and pull these two palettes out of my drawers over there just so we could take a look at them. Because I know for a lot of people, you might already have one or both of these and you want to know kind of how these compare to these right here. So first off, let's talk about this palette right here. This is the Desert Dusk palette. And when it comes to all three of the nudes that we're looking at today, I didn't find a ton of similarities right here in the light palette. I did see quite a few in the medium palette right here, like this caramel orange, and then a couple of these shimmers are pretty present if you're looking like here, here, and then a little bit of this shimmery purple. So there is a fair amount of comparison to be found between these on this side of the palette. Now, as far as the deep palette goes, I'm not even going to touch that palette because it's getting everywhere at this point, but I'll go ahead and throw up a picture on the screen for you guys because there are quite a few similarities in the deeper end of that palette as well from what I can see online. Definitely like the purple, there's like this deep kind of metallic-y shimmer red also in that palette. That's one of the ones that came out. And then here, of course, is the light one. Now this one for me, the new nude palette, like this combination all day long, they look so similar. Even like the border of the mini palette looks the same. Like the entire aesthetic overall is definitely there. So as far as I'm concerned, do I think that if you have this one right here, again, this is the new nude, do you need this? I mean, it's going to be a little bit of a tricky one to justify because, yes, they are different. Like, they don't have the exact same shades, quote unquote. This one right here, this purple shimmer, that is not in here. There isn't, like, a glittery, bright purple shimmer. But if you cover that shade up, you can see a lot of the other shades in the little one are very close to shades that are in here. But, you guys, those are my thoughts and opinions. Again, my first impression on these palettes. We went through, we came, we saw, we played, we swatched as best we could. And I apologize if this is not what you expected or, you know, it's just different. Things happen. We know it happens, but if this is your first time here, just know typically things go a little bit different. But overall, it was nice to get to like dive in and play with the formula and all that good stuff. Now, I do want to hear from you guys down below. And of course, if you haven't done so yet, please subscribe and turn on your post notifications to this here YouTube channel. Because if you have forgotten, hello, hi, my name is Paige and I upload 5 videos a week. That's right. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Girl, we are bringing you fun, fresh, early content. It goes up bright and early between 6 and 7 a.m. my time here in good old Northern Michigan. So you can watch it in the morning. You're getting up. You're getting the kids ready. You're doing your life. You're doing your thing, girl. Subscribe and turn on your post notifications and do it with me and hang out and let's drink some coffee together. Let's live our lives, girl. So subscribe and turn on your post notifications. But you guys, that is it. Thank you so much for watching. Please do not forget to have a great day, night, weekend, whatever it is when you're watching this. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye. And I don't care. In with my baby, yeah. All the good things disappear. Yeah, 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 yeah. Thank you. Thanks, Mom. You're swell. You're the best mom ever. Okay. Oh, I didn't swatch it. Whoops, it is. Oh, just swatching this makes me feel some kind of way. Oh, I knew I forgot something. I was like, what's going happening? Paige, who are you? What is your claspy showing? Because that's unacceptable.